His belt still rests with the Latin heartthrob, Al Perez. So now we continue with Bruiser Brody coming to the ring. And as he gets up there, it may get wild. Let me go ahead and throw it to Chris Kirsten. This is what I'm talking about. Chris is going to have to bail out before he can even announce it. Bruiser Brody comes to the ring with a gasoline can.
From Albuquerque, New Mexico, Bruiser Brody.
Don Gay has joined me here in the broadcast booth. And Don, do you see how smashed up that can is now from being hit over the head of Abdullah the Butcher?
Abdullah is having some problems right now, but this is going to be a wild match.
Don, I'd hope to talk to you a little bit about a steel cage rematch here on the second, but we're going to have to watch this for all it's worth right now. Here comes Brody with that patented Bruiser Brody stomp.
People are going to get their money's worth tonight in this one.
Don, why don't you go out there and tell those two guys to break it up? Would you do that for me right now?
No, I don't think so. I believe that my chance-taking days are over with. Bull riding would be a piece of cake at this point.
Listen, I don't think you're on ever anything any meaner than these two. They are going at it in brutal fashion in the ring. Ralph Pulley watches with a grimace on his face. He's the referee. Here comes Bruiser Brody outside. He's climbing the ropes on Abdullah the Butcher from the Republic of the Sudan.
Abdullah still reeling from that gas can explosion.
Don, it is going to be exciting when that steel cage is put up around the ring. Kevin Von Erich versus Brian, it is.
What a match that will be.
And you're to be given credit for some of that. You saw what happened and immediately got with matchmaker Ed Watt.
We had to get something put together because, you know, Kevin was upset, visibly upset, and so was I. And we want to give these people at the Mesquite Arena their money's worth, and they're getting it right now. Abdullah.
Well, what I'm concerned about now is the right hand of Abdullah the Butcher. He has been known to use a foreign object that he pulls from his tights, and I think he just slid it back in right then.
I think he hit it from the referee. But I think it's all as fair, you know, from gas can to that.
Well, that's a good point as Abdullah now pounds his own hard head into that of Bruiser Brody along the ropes. Fans are standing in the ringside area here in the Mesquite Arena.
I don't even think my bull rope would have fit on Abdullah.
Oh, my, that's not a pretty sight.
Look at that hold on the eye.
I'm glad the camera's backed away. Because Bruiser Brody is not exactly in wedding picture form right now.
Not a pretty sight. These two monsters are going at it.
This is as dangerous a confrontation as you'll ever see in professional sports as Abdullah the Butcher.
It could
lowers
be over.
The elbow. 1, 2.
He just gets away.
So close.
That was some animal instinct right there. Bruiser Brody was all but done for. How he got by that, I'll never know.
Each man is slow to get up now. Fans urging Bruiser Brody on. These two have had some classic confrontations over the last 13 months. There's a head in the turnbuckle, and Bruiser Brody reels away.
Abdullah pushing the issue.
Bruiser Brody can get that foot higher than anyone I've ever seen as he downs Abdullah, and that's quite a feat at 400-plus pounds.
Whoa, how much punishment can they take?
Look at those people back there. Some of them look, some of them are afraid to.
Just had to back away from the ring. They're getting splashed.
Bruiser Brody, one of the world-renowned stars of pro wrestling, here with world-class in Mesquite against the dreaded Abdullah the Butcher, who's barred in many parts of the world.
Uh-oh.
There's some sort of claw move, and I'm afraid that may have been a little below the belt, Don.
I think he set that up. The referee was behind, couldn't see it, and I think, I think he got smooth away. Bruiser gonna get a breath, but he better look out. Abdullah's just going to continue the chase.
Hey, no ring is big enough to hold these two, and they're out on the table. Chris is trying to save your microphone there for you, Don. And he may have to worry about saving himself here if they move any closer. Here's Bruiser trying to flatten a chair. Abdullah doesn't know where he is. Look out! Boom! He smashes that chair off of Abdullah's shoulder.
Abdullah is reeling. He may fall into the front row of the ringside seats.
They struggle out there as fans scamper away. No telling where they may go or what may happen. They're outside into the ringside area.
We've had bulls in the arena before. The fence should hold them, but the people are going to have to watch out. What a match.
7,000 people scamper either to get away or to get into position to see here as they're back behind the ringside area out on the rodeo ground. Abdullah the Butcher and Bruiser Brody, this is what you can expect to see whenever these two get together.
This looks like a match to the finish. I don't think they're going to pay attention to the referee at all.
They don't even know there's a referee out there right now. There's Ralph in the middle of them, though. Bruiser following Abdullah the Butcher away. What a mess.
He can't see, I don't think. He has so much blood in his eyes, he's just feeling his way.
They're over there next to one of our cameras up on a platform. I hope they don't knock it down. They're right into it. We're not going to be able to pick up any more of this, so we're going to get out before it gets worse.
What a match. What a match.